Hey everyone, it's Justin again. I'm back for the next part of our road trip around the United States, and I've made it to the Midwest. So far on our road trip, we've learned about location and one type of map, road maps. A road map can help us navigate around places, remember? But what if I wanted to know more about what a place was like? Are there mountains there? What's the weather like? How many people live there? Well, there are other types of maps that can answer those kinds of questions for us. Today, we'll identify the features of different types of maps. And then you'll read different maps to learn more about the Midwest region of the United States. Let's go! There are many types of maps, each with a specific purpose. Let's start with a political map. Political maps help us see governmental boundaries. They show us countries, states, cities, and the location of significant places like the Capitol. This is a political map of the United States. We can see the state boundaries and the countries that border the US. Let's focus in on this section of each map to learn more about the Midwest. Pause the video here to complete page 3 of your PDF to learn more about the political boundaries of this region. In the Midwest, I see states like Wisconsin, Minnesota, Iowa, and more. I can learn the capital cities of the states in this region by looking for the star icon. And I can also see which state's boundaries line up with the Mississippi River, or with another country, Canada, to the north. Next up, we have physical maps. Physical maps show the natural features of a place, like landforms and bodies of water. Here is a physical map of the United States. The green represents flat land. The red represents elevated land, like mountains. I also see rivers and lakes. If we focus on the Midwest region, what kind of physical features do you see? Pause the video here and complete page 4 of your PDF to learn more about the physical features of the Midwest. Based on the map, I can tell that the Midwest has mostly flat land, with some hills and the beginnings of mountains over here in the west. I also see the Great Lakes and some rivers in this region. Awesome! Let's keep going and learn about climate maps. A climate map provides information about the general weather of an area, like temperature or humidity. This map helps us understand the kind of weather a place usually experiences. This climate map of the United States shows that different regions experience different temperatures. Take some time to focus on the Midwest and learn about this region's climate. Pause the video and complete page 5 of your PDF. This climate map shows me that in the Midwest, the average temperature is between 40 degrees and 70 degrees Fahrenheit. The Midwest has both cold and warm days. So far, we've learned all about the states of the Midwest and what the physical environment is like there, all from maps. And we still have 2 more maps to go that'll teach us more about the Midwest. The first kind of map that could teach us about life in a region is a population map. Population maps show how many people live in a specific area. The amount of people who live in one place can affect all aspects of life. This is a population map of the United States. We can see which places have a lot of people living there and which places do not. Pause here and complete page 6 in your PDF to learn more about the population of the Midwest. The population map shows me that while there are some areas with a higher population, most of the Midwest has a lower population of people living there. Finally, we have economic maps. Economic maps show information related to businesses and money. One example is a map that shows how much money people earn from their jobs. Another example is a map that shows the major types of industries or resources in an area. Pause the video one more time to complete page 7 in your PDF and finish learning about the Midwest region. Thanks to these economic maps, I now know that households in the Midwest typically earn between $55,000 and $75,000 per year. I also know that some natural resources that come out of the Midwest include livestock and produce, oil, coal, fish, and lumber. Whew! We learned so much about the Midwest today just by reading maps. Knowing how to read different types of maps is like having a toolbox full of tools. Just like how we use hammers and wrenches for different jobs, we can use different maps to learn different things about a place. Next time on our road trip, we'll be going one step further and analyzing what life in a place must be like based on what we learn by reading maps. I can't wait to learn all about the West with you on our final stop on our road trip. See you next time. Hey.